Currently, the 0.4mm nozzle is the standard for majority of 3D printers. It provides fast and detailed prints, and printing fiber filaments is possible with quite a high success rate without clogging. But what if you want a nozzle size that still provides good enough details and doesn't clog at all? This is where we run into a problem. The industry standard are the 0.2, 0.4 and 0.6 nozzle sizes. From my experience, that makes little sense because while we reduce or increase the diameter of a nozzle by not that much, the area where the filament comes out changes way more drastically. So if we go with bigger nozzles, we start to lose a lot of details on the prints, they ooze more, and it is generally harder to control the retractions with a bigger opening. So then the question is, why do we have to skip right to the 0.6mm nozzle if a 0.5 one should be enough to ensure no clogging, better print details and less stringing? That would make this nozzle size the most universal one that can do it all. I'm not the only one who thinks this way, so I compared 0.4, 0.5 and 0.6 nozzle prints in detail to see if my theory was correct. I also made multiple projects to form a more concrete opinion. So let's find out if most of us were missing out on something special. I usually do all the testing like this on my X1C, but because even after market hotends don't have a 0.5mm size, I chose my trusted VORON 2.4. I reached out to Fatos and they provided the upgrades and filaments needed to make this comparison. Huge thanks to them. I chose the Rapido2 high flow hotend and their new hardened steel and coat nozzles, which supposedly last way longer due to their harder coating. They also released quite a few new products like their new APUS2 extruder and conch hotends for bamboo printers. For the upgrade, I also chose to make a few parts using today's video sponsor PCBWay MGF 3D printing service from Nylon. I thought I would shoot two birds with one stone by increasing the plastic's heat resistance, which will allow me to run the extruder at high power and test the manufacturing tolerances for future projects. This process seems to be very precise considering these parts are 3D printed and all extrusions and holes have a light fit. So if you are designing or modifying files, you only have to adjust clearance just a tiny bit compared to the FDM printers we have at home. With all upgrades and calibrations done, I selected 4 main prints that serve a real functional purpose. Some require more details, some less, and some just need to be dimensionally accurate. We all know that the higher the nozzle size, the fewer details we will have, but by how much exactly? To properly answer this question, I had to create quite a few new profiles and make flow rate and pressure advance calibrations for each of 4 filaments and for each of 3 nozzles. I dried all the filaments using the Sunlu S4 dryer and during the print I used the ABUS Polyphemus. I started with printing filament clips from Fatos carbon fiber filled PTG, so probably no surprise to anyone the 0.4mm nozzle made the most detailed print that would be perfectly usable. The 0.5 nozzle's details were noticeably downgraded, but the part still looks pretty decent and would be fully usable. Meanwhile, I can't say the same about the 0.6 one. The functional details here look almost non-existent, and by my standards, this print is no longer acceptable. But just keep in mind that this was quite a small print, so the next model is a way bigger hook clip. I printed these from Fatos glass fiber filled ASA filament. On this one, it is hard to spot any difference between the nozzle sizes as the sharpest details have a larger radius than all the tested nozzles. So the only way to differentiate the prints is by looking at the top layers. While functionally all the prints perform more or less the same, the smaller nozzles made a better looking surface. Just like before, the 0.5 print looks decent, but the 0.6 one has a way more significant visual downgrade. Next, the bit holder prints with Fatos glass fiber filled PET filament. Again, we can easily notice how much detail we are losing when using a 0.6mm nozzle. Meanwhile, the 0.5 still looks acceptable and still provides the grip increasing details. However, for this functional print, it is much more important to be dimensionally accurate and strong. By the design, the bit should fit quite loosely. That was the case with a 0.4 and 0.5 nozzle prints, but not with a 0.6mm as it had way less play. I also tried to test if I could break the parts in a realistic use case scenario, but I was unable to do so as it required too much force and all prints were able to withstand the same amount of torque. This is not a scientific experiment, but Stefan from CNC Kitchen already showed the 0.4 versus 0.8 nozzle prints result in almost identical lay adhesion. The greatest strength comes from the added material. The final print of the comparison is a PTFE guide for X1 and P1 printers. I feel like this one sums up pretty well the difference. The print with a 0.4 nozzle looks basically flawless, with 0.5 still looks decent and acceptable, But yet again with a 0.61, the print quality degrades way too much, at least for my standards. However, this is a functional print and the dimensional accuracy of a PTFE tube guide hole is the most important thing. Both prints with 0.4 and 0.5 nozzles had a proper loose fit that represented the original design the best, and the 0.61 was too tight, not allowing for the play. I never tested this topic thoroughly until now, but so far it seems that all the comparisons represent quite well my experience with these nozzles from the past. But the question then is, would I make the 0.5mm nozzle the primary on my VORON? It has a bigger build plate, so I usually print larger functional parts with this printer. I used to make a lot of DIY lighting projects, but as I transitioned fully to a 3D printing channel, I really missed making that kind of stuff. So during the testing phase, I designed and printed 3 projects with a 0.5mm nozzle. For the first one, I wanted to make a high CRI floodlight that uses an efficient heatsink from an old GPU. With a successful test print from PLA, I made some adjustments and printed the final parts using Fatos glass fiber filled nylon and PET filaments. For a project like this, any of these two materials would work, but I couldn't pass up an opportunity to make a light that has a Nocta fans color scheme. All prints stuck extremely well to the plate and had zero warping, which is a key for a design like this. Most glass-filled filaments have much larger fibers than carbon ones, which makes a more defined texture on the prints and hides layer lines very well. But as I learned from past testing, there can be hidden scenarios with the glass filaments where some nozzles can decrease the adhesion without you even realizing it. In that case, the 0.4mm E3D Diamondback had a rough inside surface that might have narrowed the nozzle's diameter, leading to some sort of micro-clogging and lower adhesion strength. It was a sad discovery because the 0.5mm size most likely prevented that. Then I used the carbon fiber filled PTG to print parts for a DIY flashlight with the electronics I had lying around. While it won't rival any lights even from more budget brands, the simplicity and the fact that I made it myself from scratch just feels good. However, prints with fiber filaments are usually significantly less stringy. So for the final project, I printed from a regular SA filament, again using the 0.5mm nozzle. While there were some unwanted strings, there was nothing major that would significantly impact the final look. I also tried some of the new PTG Pro by InstLogic, as PTG filaments like to use a lot more. The 0.5mm nozzle again had no excessive stringing problem, and without direct comparison to a 0.4 nozzle, print details still look way more than decent. So what is conclusion from all this? Comparing all the prints as thoroughly as possible and making multiple projects with a 0.5mm nozzle, I have to say I like it so much more than the 0.61, especially for bigger printers like this VORON. It truly comes down to two things: do you print fiber filaments, and what type of prints do you make the most? First, if you don't print fiber filaments, there are only a few reasons to go for the bigger nozzles. The slightly stronger parts and faster print times if we're not limited by the max flow rate. But even in this case, with a Rapido 2 hot end that can melt the filament without no decrease in lay adhesion at 15 cubic millimeters per second, we're saving an insignificant amount of time compared to the decrease in the print quality of a 0.6 nozzle. So if you don't care about fiber filaments, you can even try lower sizes like 0.3mm. Too bad almost no one makes them. But if you want a nozzle size that can do it all, the 0.5mm one is the choice. Fiber filaments can be expensive, so minimizing the risk of failed prints due to clogging with an acceptable loss in details is a good compromise, especially if most of the time you make bigger prints that don't require high detail. So while I can see the reasons to go for the smaller nozzles to get way more details in the prints, for me it is hard to see any compelling reasons for going above 0.5mm nozzles, as those are such an amazing all-around option. It is too bad that most companies don't sell them and stick to the old standard that doesn't make much sense. But what is your opinion and experience on all this? Feel free to post it in comments below. Huge thanks to all the Patreon and YouTube members for your continued support. Well, that's all from me, I'll see you next time.